Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can send custom notification through Process Builder. So our scenario is when a case is escalated, we need to send custom notification to a public group so that you can consider that this public group is having users who sees the cases. Those are escalated by a particular case owner. So what we need to do to accomplish this requirement, we need to create a custom notification, then we need to create a public group, and then we need to create a process builder. So I'm going to create custom notification first. So you can search for notifications. So here you can see custom notification option is available. So you can click on new, and here you can type label for this. So custom notification name is escalation message. This is the API. Supported channels are both desktop and mobile. So I'm clicking on save. So our first requirement is completed. So we created a custom notification. Now we need to create a public group. So from here, I'm searching for public group. And I'm going to create new public group. So label will be escalation group, right? And here I'm going to put a user, that is Vikas Gupta. So currently I'm logged in as Sanjay Gupta, right? I will be the case owner. When I will be escalating the case, that custom notification will be sent to this public group. And in this public group, only one member is available. So when I will be logging in as Vikas Gupta, so I will see that custom notification, right? So I am now clicking on save. So here you can see this public group is created. Now we are going to create a process builder. So here I'm going to create new process builder. So case process, clicking on save. Now here we need to select an object. So I'm searching for case. Now I need to set the criteria. So is escalated. So this is the criteria name. Now I need to search for the field status. So if it is equals to escalated, and one more thing that we need to check whether it is changed or not. So is changed equals to true. So if these both conditions are true, like case status is escalated and earlier it was some other status and now it is escalated. So if both the conditions are true, then we need to apply the action. So here I'm choosing send custom notification. So escalation notification. So this will be the name of this action, right? Now I need to choose notification type. So I'm choosing escalation message. So this is notification that we created earlier at the beginning of this video. Now we need to select the notification recipient. So here we have four options. We can choose user. So three options are available here. So here we have three options: current user, find user, and user field from a record, right? So if you want to go through a particular user, then you can choose this option, owner. So you can find a particular owner, queue, group and queue. So we need to select a group. So we created a group that is escalation group. So that is available here. Now here you can type notification title. You can also merge the fields. Those are available on case. So let's say I am choosing case number is escalated. And here you can type the notification body. So here also you can merge the field. So hi, again I am choosing case number. Is escalated please to the need, right? So this title and body, you can type the message as per your requirement. Then target object is case object that started the process, and I'm clicking on save. So this way we created this. Now I'm clicking on activate, confirm. Right, so all three things we did, like we created custom notification, we created public group, and we created process builder. Now moving to case object, so I'm going to create new case. And I'm going to fill the information for this case. So status is new, priority, medium, case origin, let's say phone, and contact name, account name. These are optional lookups, so you can choose them as well. Type, let's say other, case reason, installation. Yeah, these are optional fields, so you can fill them as per your requirement. So I'm clicking on save. So that one case is created. So see, the number is 1032, right? So this will reflect when we will escalating this. So it will be available in the notification message because we merged case number field there. So now status is new. So I'm going to escalate this. Oh, so for this record type, that escalation field is not available. So I'm going to create one more case for this record type. So here, let me check first. So here escalated is available. So again, I'm saving this. So 1033 is the case that I created for escalation. Now I am selecting escalated and clicking on save, right? So now I need to search for the users and I need to log in as Vikas Gupta, because Vikas Gupta is the user who is the member of that public group. So I'm logging in as Vikas Gupta, and you will see in the notification bell, one notification will be there having escalation message. So here you can see in this bell icon, one count is available. So if I click on this, you will see 1033. So here you can see case number 1033 is escalated, and this is the title, which is in bold, and at below, hi, 1033 is escalated, please do the needful. So this is the notification body. So this way we can send custom notifications to users, owners, public group, and queues. So this we can do as per the requirement. So in our requirement, I sent this custom notification when case was escalated. In your cases, this might be possible, like when you are assigning any case from queue to user, then you want to send custom notification, or any other scenario, right? So as per your requirement, you can do those things. So remember one thing, before sending custom notification through process builder, first you need to create the custom notification, and then you can do that. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. So thank you for watching this video.